The searcher.
Return to me. Try not to die on the way back.
Yeah. Oh, come on, dude. Okay.
Just back to the old grind.
Yep. That makes twice I've died this chapter already. God damn it, dude.
The disgusting wretches have wandered my halls, have gone unchecked, crying.
Alright, who's first? Striker? Alright, then Piper, then Fisher. Makes sense, considering Striker's the first, the fastest of the three. You.
So quiet, like a welcoming grave. I like the silence, don't you?
Ah. Back to the angel.
Oh, I hate leaving work unfinished. Fortunately, I have you to pick up the pieces. But you'll have to go even deeper. Down, down, down into the abyss. Take the lift down. Say hello to an old friend. Sending you a little present.
Take the Tommy gun, if only.
Oops, I forgot. It's a little hard to get a hold of. Oh well, better luck next time.
Yeah. Because... I know I said in... I believe I said in Chapter 1 that Chapter 3 is most likely going to be in either... one or two or three different videos altogether. Most likely it's just going to be two, and in the first half of the playthrough for Chapter 3, I said that the three conditions for getting the Tommy gun is: one, the ink blob inside Heavenly Toys next to Jack's audio tape that has to be set to the ink machine. I've done that. Two, when you get to the split path and you have to choose between the demon path or the angel path, choose the demon path. I did that. Three, do not die before getting a Tommy gun. I have done that twice, unfortunately. So, I'm out. So, that's why I was not able to get the Tommy gun. Alright, let's go down. Number 14. Yep. All right. Well, here's the thing, though. I have an axe. To effectively kill the projectionist with the axe, it's close range, and I have to hit him eight times. But since it's close range, that means the projectionist will have a good chance to hit me too, and he only needs to hit me twice in order to kill me. There's some kind of valve back here that I don't know what... I don't remember what it does, though. This valve right here. I don't remember what it does. So if anyone that knows what that valve is supposed to do, please comment down below what it's supposed to do, because I have no freaking idea. Norman, no. I'm keeping an ear out for the projectionist footsteps. And also potentially keeping an eye out for his light, too. Where are you at, Norman? He's over there. Get in. Exact same way with Bendy. If you destroyed Bendy's cutouts, Bendy would know and start making his way to that location as soon as possible. The same thing with the projectionist and the ink carts. There he is. There's three so far. That is three ink carts. I still need two more, though. And I think there's only... I can't remember if there's two or three little miracle stations down here. I think there's three. But I think the location for the ink carts changes every single time, though, which is unfortunate for me. There's four. Get in. There he is, the projectionist. Go, 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 go. See ya, Norman. Oh my God. Alright. This is the last task I had to do for Chapter 3. It's officially over. Go to level 9. Oh my God.
It seems we've reached the end of my to-do list, my little errand boy.
All right, fine.
I hope you enjoyed our time together.
Eh.
I'll always treasure it. Return to the lift. It's time to go home.
That's sad.
Are you ready to ascend, my little errand boy? The heavens are waiting.
Me in heaven? I think you're tripping. Let it all out, Alice. Let it all out.
Yep. Come down and bring me back my father!
The scripting of this, though. Yeesh. Boris, behind you. Behind you, buddy.